Let me show you something. See that mess here? You know how messy environment kills your productivity? Did you also grow up with your mom forcing you to clean up every day? It's the same thing with your computer. Messy environment, files all over, hard to track configuration, doesn't only create a foggy mind and cripple your thinking, but actually kills your work efficiency, making you work longer and harder instead of sitting at the beach. Well, not in front of your computer, at least. I've been managing my .files for years as a local directory on my local machine. Thinking about cleaning my room and keeping it tidy, I kept improving. I made sure it's in sync with GitHub. Then I made another improvement and started working with symlinks. Then, at some point, I discovered Stow and felt I reached heaven. But you know what they say about rising, or risers, is this a word? Anyway, I stumbled across a blog post about Nick's home manager, and like a butterfly to fire, I was drawn to the next shiny object that seemed to be better. Even though I had the perfect solution by all metrics. Home manager was great, don't get me wrong, but it added some complexities that I kept waving off like in an abusive relationship, thinking that's the way of showing love. I had to resync the entire system with every line of code, my .config files were protected, so neither I or any other third party couldn't really change them without sudo, and every time someone would mention that in the comments to me, I'd brush them off with an excuse, thinking I was such a hipster. Hundreds of comments in, saying basically the same, made me realize this was the intervention I needed. I don't care what they say, I'm going back to my perfect setup. Nix Home Manager was one of my great discoveries this year. It's managing my Darwin environment using Nix. The next time I change a machine or would just want to reset the existing one, Nix helped me with that. In my .files, which you can also find on GitHub, there's flake.nix file that is my machine's configuration, holding system packages, system defaults like my dock, my finder, and even a login prompt customized with my name. Homebrew casks and other options are also included, and Nix was a real goldmine of options. But just be careful, because Nix is a rabbit hole that you're not coming out of anytime soon, so think twice. Then I added Home Manager, another layer that helps me set other options. But most importantly, Home Files, aka .files. The order in which they were set was captivating to me. It just came with one little quirk. You just have to sync things by running Home Manager switch after making changes to the .files. Not too hard, I thought to myself, only to figure out I was doing it dozens of times every day. It could be my personal use case. I create content for the terminal. I configure everything all the time. I create plugins, I use plugins. I'm not the average user, so there you have it, all cards on the table. But here's another quirk. Home Manager was the owner of my .files. Like an abusive partner or a bank, which is the same thing if you think about it, it took over my belongings, telling me they're safer with them. Every time I sync, it'll make sure to put things in the right place. The files weren't mine. That's okay, I thought. Home Manager knows better. Deep down inside, I wanted it to be back so much. Seeing my name on my precious files I worked so hard to build. There was another issue with that. When Home Manager owns my .config files and neither I or other processes, like Lazy, for example, can touch them, every new plugin would install its things, and when Lazy would try to update Lazy lock file, I'd get an error. That's fine, I thought, who cares about this stupid lock file anyway? According to a month ago, the Home Manager community didn't have a non-hacky way of working around this issue. But even then, I made things work. I'd ignore the issues, knowing Home Manager got my back. But here's where I broke. Working on my NeoVim config, yet again, I wanted to make a small change. Just disabling my snacks dashboard, video above on that if you're curious, and I had to sync Home Manager, and wait, and then change another option, and then wait again. No way I'm doing that again. After eliminating Home Manager, commenting everything out and syncing myself, I can make the change and observe the magic it's reflected in my system. I had to go all this round way only to come back to what most users are enjoying anyways. Who would have thought? No more Home Manager sync, good riddance. Not only my setup is easier to maintain, Lazy can update, clean and install plugins freely. No errors, no strange annoying pop-ups. My Lazy log file updates automatically and is pushed to my public.files repo every once in a while, just like a normal person. But hey, what about all the benefits? About snapshots, clean installation, safety, all of that? Well, over the course of 1 year, I didn't roll back my configuration, not even once. I made changes, I see them reflecting in my configuration, and then I commit and push them to GitHub like a normal human being. One day, when all hell breaks loose and I lose all of my configuration, hoping I had Home Manager, I'll think about putting it back. For now, it's an unnecessary change and I'm getting rid of it. But what else, you ask? What am I doing instead? Glad you asked. Stow, which many of you already know, was my go-to and it's coming back. I used to fear Stow because it's so raw. With the right configuration, allowing you to direct files, ignore others, set the target and everything else, it's one easy command away. Stow followed by my dot for the current dotfiles directory. The config file takes care of the rest. .stowrc holds my target, which is home/.config, relieving me of having to remember the right flag to set when running it. Similarly, I've configured it to ignore unnecessary files, including itself when syncing, and that's pretty much all you need. One run, which, unless you've made changes to the symlinks, isn't necessary until the next time you reconfigure a new tool. And .config path is filled with symlinks. Things that have been set directly aren't touched, the rest was set by Stow. You can change them, Stow won't be mad, he'll just be there on the next run. Let's take a quick break to talk about a worthy cause that's close to my heart. While we're dealing with microscopic decisions like which tool to configure my .files, we have to remember that almost 3 billion people have never logged onto the internet. 1 billion of them are actually students. Meet Give Internet, a charity empowering students in need by providing internet access and laptops. Through partnerships with local organizations, students gain access to skills development programs in areas like coding, design, healthcare, and entrepreneurship. The only missing tool, a laptop and a connection. Once equipped, many students secure jobs, freelance, or launch their own businesses. Every donation made through my unique link is matched by one of their founding members, doubling the impact. Find the link in the description and join the movement in just a few clicks. Explore individual student stories, track exactly how donations are spent, and receive monthly updates showing the lives transformed by your support. Visit giveinternet.org to learn more. Thank you for your attention. Now back to the video. And with that, it's time to update the README. I'm no longer using Home Manager. I'm back to good old Stow. I'll even commit push to my public repo so that you'd see it reflected when the video goes live. And here's a nice touch for that. Something I've recently added to NeoVim, where Home Manager didn't interrupt with my changes. Snacks.nvim, a new plugin that you can check my channel to see more of. With Git Browse, Snacks pops a browser window with my updated README on GitHub and everything's back to normal. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. Curious about the lit keyboard? Subscribe because the review is already in the oven. An extra word of honesty. A, it's not easy to come out and say I was wrong, especially after defending a decision I made. I'm not dealing with rocket science here. Nobody is going to save lives by using Stow or Nix, but I still care about being true to content I make because I know it means something for others. So hopefully this helps shed some light on why I made this video and how I'm planning to approach everything that comes next. Okay, so no more Home Manager and Stow is back in. While I did show the relatively simple way of doing things, there's more to it than just this. If you're after a solid startup for your .files, check out this video next to make sure you've got everything under control. Thank you for watching and I'll see you on the next one.